Hi, welcome to Jade Con Gaming. I'm Adam. Welcome to the second session of the Yong Monks D&D campaign. I'm here with Nick, Austin, and Bob, who just leveled up to their third level and therefore gained your monastic traditions. Nick, you chose...
Wave the open palm because I want to push people down flights of stairs.
Are you afraid of them getting pregnant?
Have you seen them not hit a big set of stairs?
And Austin...
Mechanically, possibly the worst decision, but I took Way of the Elementals. You know, lots of spells with save DCs running off my 12 in the stat.
You'll do fine.
I took Way of the Shadow because it lets me teleport.
Eventually.
We'll get there.
Eventually. And yeah, but there you go. All this ultra preparation to make us rim on our choices. All the same class, one of each race, one of each archetype.
Yep.
We're a nice balanced party.
There's no half elves, are there? Oh.
Oh, you. And speaking of you are the one that advised the current action that you're on. You're headed back to the monastery
for research.
Bob had found what appears to be a dragon's scale.
It is a dragon's scale. I made the check. It's a dragon's scale.
Yep, you made a check. That's what a dragon's scale looks like.
As far as you know. Yeah.
And,
no, that's what it is.
I mean, you've seen a lot of dragons, so you'd know. From hearsay.
I used my knowledge, yo.
Yeah. And your knowledge says, this is dragon's... Are you saying your character says, this is a dragon's scale?
Yes.
That is completely accurate.
That is completely accurate.
Your character is 100% sure of that.
Oh, I'm sorry. Was I being too in character during the D&D campaign?
It's a dragon's scale. The character believes in the dragon scale. Coincidentally, it is one.
I equally.
Coincidentally, it is a brick. That's a dragon scale. You wholeheartedly believe that. You're also a little insane.
Well, you know, we're pretty good at predicting things.
I didn't give you the.
No, it's behind you. Not that kind of behind you. Actually, behind you.
There you go. I was like, there's supposed to be a little mini tripod on that.
Indeed there is. I was waiting for you to give me the equipment that I needed.
Well, I'm sorry I took so long. Anyway, so you...
As long as you're sorry, I'll let it slide this time. Don't do it again.
He's so kind.
It's true.
Walk in.
You were taking a shortcut?
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
Casual pace. Gee, this moves past us quicker. But yeah, you make your way up to your home.
Mm-hmm. Right? I live here! Yep. Unless they kick me out when I get tattoos.
Nope. But you know, along your trip, yeah. Perhaps you've noticed any tattoos maybe spreading a bit.
Yeah.
I didn't notice.
You'll know. Someone else will notice next time you take your bathrobe off.
Yes. I'm going to Arthur Dent my way through this whole thing.
But do you have a towel?
Yes.
Okay. I was just making sure you were prepared.
Bathrobes are just giant wearable towels.
Exactly.
How specific can a crude shape be? I can take 1 foot of an element and make it into a crude shape.
Okay.
What qualifies as crude? Like, is a humanoid form too specific, or is
well, maybe they just mean crude, like socially unacceptable, like lining the road with phallus.
That is not what they mean. You can make a form that is humanoid. You might not, but you wouldn't be able to say make it look like
a person,
an individual by any means. Yeah,
or probably even
differently. My best thought is I can use it to make handholds. I just made climbing mountains way easier.
You already...
it's not good enough until I can just teleport to the top of the mountain by thinking hard enough.
He'll beat you to that one.
No, he can only move 30 feet.
That's true.
I thought it was 60.
No.
Okay.
And shadow through shadow. You ever seen the shadows on the top of the mountain? There aren't many.
And they're under the trees up there.
What trees? It's rock. There's no green painted on top.
There is a tree right there.
But that's over here.
Yes.
I'm talking about this.
Okay.
Just put Globe of Darkness up there.
No shadows. That's just darkness.
I believe that falls within what he'll be able to do. But anyways, that's the future. So what do you do when you make it back to the monastery?
Talk about the future.
One, check in with our Mr. Wax.
Wax on. Really, I gave him the easiest name to remember, you know, so I'll remember it.
Yeah. We're going to check in on the boss. Tell him the dragon did it.
Show him the scale, let him know our suspicions, then, you know, good
I
research.
I offer humbly. I'll go and talk to the other dragon and see what it knows. With permission, of course. Having in the past been told explicitly not to.
He says, you know, hopefully it does not come to that. This very well may have been left over from some great time ago.
Now, the earthquake was like a couple weeks ago.
That it was in the fountain. Happened.
It was in a fountain.
Dragons do things.
Well, then perhaps someone else had found it and
who threw it into a fountain? What a monster.
So, let him know our thoughts, and now we're going to further research on the possibility.
Eventually I'm going to get permission to go see that dragon.
Or just do it.
Eventually he gets permission.
I'm not willing to actually just go and do it. They told me not to.
Yeah, gets permission there. they told me that's pretty far down the list, though. But eventually, you'll meet him.
Around level 14.
So, do my investigation.
I can read.
You're not supposed to...
Don't read the DM notes, man.
In my defense,
don't make them put up the DM screen.
There is no screen.
These are not DMs.
I was trusting you.
That shows how that was a bad decision.
Yeah, I know it does.
But you've never trusted me before, so I assumed I was allowed to read it.
I've trusted you all the time before. It may not have always turned out my way, but whatever.
You just trust me to be me.
Research. Investigation. Not bad.
Can I research things as well?
Is that what you want to do with your time, or do you want to take a really relaxing bath check?
You don't need to check. He just went. He succeeds.
Help.
do you need someone to assist? Give you advantage?
No, he makes a really good bath.
I nailed that bath.
19.
Nailed it.
18 on the investigation.
Okay.
Searching all of our books. I should know about where everything is by this point, but...
I practiced my new fire powers.
Waxon is really rather impressed that you've...
Yeah,
I mean, you've been... I mean, ultimately, I mean, it's you, so the fact that you've developed so quickly at this point is not the most surprising, but I mean, it is very impressive still.
Yeah, no.
Also impressive you picked that path.
Yeah, go ahead and take some extra, you know... Lessons.
It's less considered the idea of you do not pick your path. You have not chosen, I want this. It's how you develop.
It is how you are.
Mm-hmm. But obviously, I wasn't going to just randomly determine what path you go down. That wouldn't be fun for you as players.
Would have been a hoot.
Okay, that wouldn't have been fun for Bob as a player.
I would have been annoyed. My character would have developed a new weird thing that he did.
In fact, I feel like if he had gotten what you wanted, the fact that you didn't get to choose it still would have bothered you.
No, I would have been fine then.
We did? Okay. So there was a 1 in 3 chance he would have been okay.
Yes.
Actually, the elemental one would have been fine as well.
Just not that.
Mm. Yeah, the douchebag one I don't want.
Yeah.
Come on, I give him to explode people's hearts.
No, the skill set isn't a douchebag. Your character is a douchebag.
Oh, yeah.
It's you. It's
you as an individual. Nothing against what you can do.
Oh, yeah.
All three of the monk paths are solid choices.
But anyways. Yeah, you actually spend a couple days, going through various things in here, largely because of some of the notes that you find. You don't much care for what they say. If anything, it seems that legend and history have been blended.
Yeah.
But we'll get to that. You have a couple days, other than some practicing and
days without
taking
missions,
your
training.
You know,
as you
do,
like,
do you assist some
day?
Of the lesser non. You know, monks without markings of power and how to nap best.
I know other stuff.
I know other stuff? This is not my only character trait.
No, that's just who they send
how
me.
How to create illusions. Show off.
No. I don't show off. I'm a humble monk in my bathrobe.
I show off.
yes, you do.
Yeah, he shows
people
off.
People are impressed.
No, yeah. I still...
I try and drag rookies up on my training path and tell them that when they class halfway through, because I know they can't handle it, that they will one day.
Yeah. Have you been doing that for good long time?
What?
Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah, you've had at least one that's died.
Died?
Died.
That's sad. Come back with the idea that the monk's path is not for everyone.
I try to go with him on his training path.
Really?
You get like halfway and you find this amazing shady spot. Looks really comfortable.
I'm faster than him, as long as we're not climbing.
It's mostly climbing.
His way's climbing.
Mostly climbing. Eventually, he makes a little handhold out of the stone and say, you can use that if you're a pussy. That's the pussy handhold.
Nope, my handholds will only last for 1 minute.
Oh.
I shape stone into a shape for 1 minute. Or water, or fire.
So you outrun them so they're a minute behind, climb to the top of the cliff and wait. You're taking forever! We saw him climb the cliff and he was just...
Well, to be fair, every 6 seconds he has to stop and, you know, make another handhold.
No, I don't. I can climb without him.
Yeah.
It's just now I can make them.
He can now make them for others to follow, more of anything. For one, you find that, you know, of course there have been... There are known to be 4 dragons.
Mm-hmm.
The one with the, you know, I believe you found a metallic black scale, yes?
Yeah,
that sounds right.
Black scale.
That would have, at some point, belonged to Shou Yong.
The despoiler, the evil, the ravaging. Hmm? It's a dragon, it's got a second name.
No. Hmm.
Shou Yong, that black guy?
yes, the black one. We didn't give it any other names. Oh. What does he do? Well, he shows up and destroys everything. Maybe the destroyer? Maybe?
We thought that would be racist.
It's like probably,
while not given as a title, if anything, he is the Dragon of Beasts.
Hmm.
He's not... He was last raid to rest something close to 900 years ago. And you find no mention of snakes in regards to him.
Beasts are animals, are snakes.
You do, however... find this part being particularly where it seems that legends have mixed in over time. It's been a long time, but you do find mentions of wolfmen or werewolves. That
oh god, more werewolves, really?
Well, that would be completely absurd.
Even more close to where rats.
Yeah, no. The idea of werewolves are
hands.
We can't do damage to them without silver.
Keep ones.
No, you can't do damage to them without silver.
Fire.
It doesn't matter. The idea of werewolves is absurd. You take that as legend. Mm-hmm. If anything, he might have used wolves in the past, as he was obviously using snakes this time, and some attributes.
Why would werewolves be absurd?
Because that's the kind of thing that doesn't exist.
No magic.
I can shoot fire out of my hands.
Yeah, you but you can't shapeshift.
there
are no other shapeshifters.
Not shapeshifting, I'm just like the idea of there are dragons, I can shoot fire out of my hand, why is it so crazy that there's a wolf person?
Because
there's like pointy ear people.
Yeah, those are just another kind of person.
It's like I'm willing to accept maybe a giant wolf that people mistake for a man.
I gotta go with that.
Yeah, that's sort of where you feel it has to be something on there.
I just feel like I'm a little more fantastic. I'm open to it. Sure, it exists. I don't see why I couldn't. That'd make the world a lot more interesting. A lot more interesting.
It's probably beyond the mist.
Probably out there.
But,
that's why I need that water to ice power. Boosh.
But anyways, that's ultimately, you're not necessarily sure that you find conclusive information here. You'd want to find other sources, but after a couple days, you've pretty much done all you can with
all the stuff here. Do I even know if the other places have libraries?
I mean, who would you ask to find out? I mean,
yeah, I would ask someone, like, one of the trainee monks if they know. Or send them down there to go find out at the beginning.
One of the trainee or people that trains? Someone older or someone younger? Who are you asking?
Younger. Someone not quite our level, but...
Someone younger is unlikely to have any idea. Most of them haven't actually left the monastery.
Oh, if they're not allowed to leave the monastery, then no. It's like, I was just going to send them out as an errand boy to check.
There's no urchins here for you to boss around.
They're not for you to boss around. You're not at a point, you have not taken a position as an instructor here, unless you do so, then...
Yeah, can I go take a position as an instructor?
No.
You just take
I'm not yet.
You just take some and tell them what to do. That's what I do.
Well, if I can't do that, I'm going to take a nap and protest. I'm going to sleep in an inconvenient place.
Middle of the training field.
Today's lesson is to train without waking him up. Now, all the students think it's difficult, but really...
He's not like I'm sleeping on the top of one of the bars. Just like...
You have to skip that bar.
Now, I first, because I figure he's been about, ask Wax on if the other towns have, you know, libraries.
Yeah, he would point out that, yeah, there are certainly some libraries. Are you, I guess, expressing why you're interested?
It's like, I found some information on here, but it mixed fact and legend. We want to see if they have any more information.
He does point out that
Shui
Town and Taiko City both have their own libraries of their own. However, if you're looking about something from that long ago, you're at a point now, you could, you know, attempt to go seek the elves, who have a much longer lifespan.
Could go home, I guess.
This is home.
Yeah, this is home.
You didn't grow up there.
No, I just meant I could go visit those people who just dropped me here. Not bitter about that at all. But
I left my family. They kept wanting me to do stuff.
And now you've finally reached the point here where they're starting to want you to do stuff.
Time to leave.
Yeah, time to leave. Spent the last, 60 years snoozing my... spent some good time taking nappers. Really, the path I took is the only choice to get a full night's sleep.
I know the marks of power give us. Would we need any other markings or things to go ask them questions?
Generally, go into the jungle and have your bear your marks. Perhaps you would enjoy. I think we have some lounge pants. Would lounge pants be good?
Why would I need lounge pants? I enjoy a generous breeze around my genitals.
How about a sturdier belt to let the back of your robe hang off without...
Your point being that you can't show your mark because it's on your back and your clothes covered up.
I'm fine with a little nudity.
He's concerned that the elves might be offended.
I tell you the to the letter, what is expected in Elfish Code? Rather, I talked to them well. I was completely besides the point.
No, you're telling me that I'm like, I'm an elf halfling. Little half-breed over here trying to tell me how to be an elf. I'm elfier than you'll ever be.
Yes, but I bet
you don't understand how to interact with them.
Yeah.
I understand, I just don't care. It's not that I don't get it, it's that I don't care.
The idea is you're entering their territory and you want to come out alive.
I should be fine, totally from there.
Been there, done that.
Good luck with that, but...
Hey, it's not my fault, it's on my back. I'll just take off my robe and be like, boom, there, put it back on.
They will have shot you.
Yeah. Before you know they're there is when they're killing you. That is the idea of the jungle.
Elves are homicidally xenophobic.
But you're like
homicidally xenophobic.
An elf, though.
You're walking that away. You're obviously not
one of them.
Yeah.
You are their species. You are not of their culture.
That's stupid. These elves are retarded.
They're psychotic and xenophobic.
Yes, both of those are true. But
once again, you've made a society that's stupid.
It's not stupid. It's
but that's the society that's more or less imprisoning your society, not...
I'll just tie it around the waist and then tie the arms.
That's why he was offering you a better belt.
Unfortunately, my backpack covers up my mark.
You got a bigger mark. You're like...
Your mark's a bit bigger.
Yes, which means it goes down my back.
You can just keep your backpack.
It also extends up your shoulders.
Nope. That's not the way we discussed the tattoo and how it's working.
You're able to droop your backpack where at least from your back they can see it.
That'd be uncomfortable.
Yeah, the elves are magic. They can see your magic markings.
Anyway, you guys can chalk your marks as you go. Do you have? Is that what you want to do?
Yeah, I figure that's the best research, and we can also check there and see if they've had any interesting encounters with snakes.
What I think is fun is this conversation happened without me there because I was sleeping.
Now you're there at this point.
Someone had to come and wake me up.
Yeah.
It's like once I decided on a course of action of we should probably go talk to the elves, I woke you guys up and or got you off the mountain.
Taking my bag. We're looking for trees like this. With these type of leaves. These are the ones near the elf territory.
Alternatively, we open the mountain and you can just say there.
Because you stole a twig.
Yeah. From deep in their territory, yeah.
I've been there.
I've been there, done that. These are special elf trees. They don't grow near us. They're over there. You guys look at the twig. Fast.
I look at the trees down there. No, they're the same. It's just slightly, maybe deeper, I'm guessing. But they are the same trees.
Different trees. These are elf trees. You can tell they're different. I've got a twig and it hasn't turned into like crumbled up nothing dust. It's an elfin tree.
Anyways, what border do you head for?
The closest one?
One would assume somewhere in the archives it gives a general location of their cities?
Not really, no.
Let's see.
Are they nomadic?
So wait, our goal is to get
caught? No, you wouldn't know.
Our goal is to get caught or not get caught.
Get caught.
Oh, then we just walk through and make a lot of noise.
Yeah, true enough.
I did the opposite to not get caught.
Yes. It's like, or in that case, really, come down near the
really
Red Force.
Really permissive elves on patrol that day.
It's like, he's 12.
Yeah, there was either some, I was either really good, or there were some elves, they're just like, it's a kid, let him go. There was a really
Is he
going
to turn around? Okay, he's not trying to get through the jungle, he can live.
Yeah, that's what happened there.
Do you stick together heading down?
Yeah. Okay. Or, to get to the woods.
Yeah.
As in, he runs ahead, and then
wait
in
the woods.
Catch up.
Yeah.
You can't necessarily. Woods is the jungle is a very broad.
Well, yeah. See, I'm Lyric up here, and I point to like this cost, and I'm like,
except
we'll get there.
We're going to this one.
Okay, so fine. You end up at different spots.
Then we'll go there. Wherever you want to go, it doesn't matter. We'll go there.
It's like, make sure to make a big fire or something so let us know where you're at. Or you could just...
whole woods are on fire.
Knock, knock.
Hey, I assume he knows how to make a controlled signal fire.
Oh, I don't...
Just because they're woods, you can have fire in woods without it burning
out
of control.
Why do you travel separately?
Because he wants to go fast, and we're not as fast.
You're walking most of the way. He's faster.
Yeah, but he wants to climb down the mountain. We want to walk down the path. That's his choice. He insists on speed.
You gave him that background. It's your fault.
No, I took that background. It's my fault. The point is, I'm running. I'll wait for him there. I can set a small fire. It's part of my monk prestidigitation.
All right, so you make a signifier that points out your location.
I can use like a torch. A torch is a fire. It's a bright light.
Okay, so by evening, very easy to find.
Yeah,
and perhaps that's around the time maybe you guys make it down. It's night. Do you
no,
camp?
Camp.
Yeah.
I was like, so torch, let's go.
Let's go during the day when we're rest. You know, easier to see our marks. So we don't get shot as much. I know we can see in the dark. We don't see color that well, though.
I can make fire.
Just
out
easy,
my hands.
Just easier to go
down the
day.
Do you vote with, we just walked a long way, we're going to sleep now?
I'm fresh as a daisy.
It's like, fine, I guess you guys want to rest.
Yes, rest.
Okay.
To go during the day, you know, when normal people are awake.
It's like elves can see in the dark, right?
Yes, but
they
don't.
They're like dogs. Or cats. Which one can see in the dark? Just looking at both. Looking at both of you with your pointy ears. You guys like animals, right?
Oh, I thought you were talking about his color blindness.
No. That'd make him like a dog.
So this was all one color. Could you see through the wall?
It's a good one. Yes. So yeah, we were rested for a night at the edge of the forest.
Jungle.
Yep.
Whatever.
Jungle forest. Mostly the same thing.
That big area full of trees.
Lin Jungle. But, so I guess, pretty early, yeah.
Let's see. So, how long would it take me to cross the mountain?
Two hours?
2 hours?
I don't know.
Three hours?
Probably longer.
Four?
Maybe.
Prohibitively long.
Four?
Fine! We'll disrupt the session to measure things! Austin, I'm glad you want to do this.
More specific question. Can I climb to the top of the mountain and come back before they wake up?
You're tired.
Is that a yes or a no?
Yes, you can.
Yes.
Well, he's still
take about 3 hours each way. Maybe a little more.
So you won't get to sleep that night.
Yeah, like a few hours of sleep.
And be at disadvantage on all tasks tomorrow.
That's true. A little too long.
Prohibitively.
Yeah, prohibitively long. Alright.
Should have just said that.
Also, would have really messed up the fact that a little ways into the night...
That's my point. I was thinking, I wonder if I can go back to the peak and get some snow for tea in the morning.
No, you just give up.
Eventually, he's going to make it where he just... You know what? If you manage to skip out on these fights, you don't level up that session.
But I was here for some other things, so...
He fought the mountain.
Yeah. If anything, I get more experience.
Nope. None. You keep disrupting.
Hey, at least it's not me this time.
You're just in a bathroom, but at least you stick with the party. Ish.
What do you mean, ish?
As best you can, one of your party members is running off.
Hey, it's not my fault they're not serious about the training.
I'm the party. He runs off from me.
You're such a party.
I'm in the bathrobe. I clearly brought the party.
All right, but yeah, in tonight, you're seeing, who's on watch?
Watch?
Mm-hmm. One of you?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Depending on when it is.
First watch.
First watch and me.
Okay.
So do I get my 2 hours of sleep?
Mm-hmm.
So they're all cranky, I'm still fresh as a daisy.
Let's see, 10-5 doesn't hit you, 22 probably does, and 12-5 doesn't. Am I right?
No, I have an AC of 12.
12? Oh, so two of them hit you. Then you're definitely going to notice as the arrows that come flying out of the air pierce into you.
No, he gets chances to deflect.
Yeah, he does.
I get one.
Okay. And that, do you just deflect, or...?
It's D10 plus dex to reduce damage, right?
And then okay, if you so go 10 over to... If you go, get 10 sure, over to damage, you can catch the arrow and throw it back.
Yeah, no, I'm just reducing damage. I'm certainly not going to roll more. Yeah, they would have to roll 1 damage, and with no bonuses. For me, and I would have to roll max to be able to do get 10 over.
These arrows happen D10. To be poisoned, but I guess for your deflect, I'm only going to count... the actual arrow damage, so the first arrow that you possibly have that chance with, I guess, is going to be 6 piercing damage.
6 piercing damage.
So you have to roll 16 or better.
Yeah, D10 plus dex plus monk. So it's a D10 plus 4. 6.
So you smack it away.
All right, so you do not take any damage from that?
No, I've reduced it by 6.
Okay. Then that one doesn't damage you.
That's like something. What the? Arrows!
My instincts!
But hey, the first one was the one that missed, so you hit her. Thunk. The next one does 4 piercing and 9 poison.
13 damage.
He would have died if he took that first one.
Probably.
Probably. I would be unconscious. Not dead. We get death saving throws.
Point being, you can cry out to wake your friends up.
I do. I set the forest on fire.
fortunately, he's not near a forest. He's only near the jungle.
The point is, I don't know what the attacker is, so I'm going to put a lot of obstacle between me and the trees, and that obstacle is going to be fire.
You are very easily aware of what direction they came from.
Oh, they didn't come
it's
from the
opposite direction
of the trees.
Of the trees.
Oh, okay. I was like, they came from the trees. I'm just set all of them on fire.
It's actually the opposite direction. It's coming up from the hill as the hill starts.
Wow, oh, way over there.
Not that far, but from that direction.
Yeah, then I make noise and I get, and I take, dodge action.
Okay. Otherwise, let's see. What does yours come out to be?
14. Mine's higher than theirs.
14.
I know. What?
No, 14. You're 15.
I don't
your AC. AC or initiative?
Initiative.
Oh, I thought you said AC. It's like
he just said yours.
Yeah, I just said yours.
Well, you said 14.
It's like, just answer.
It's plus 1.
Okay, plus
so 1. That's 11.
Also plus 1? Also plus 1. Okay, that's
fine. It's that 10 that threw me. You're comes out to 14. That sounds like an AC, not an initiative.
We're doing passive.
Yeah, it's passive. And comes out to 14.
Can I see the attacker?
No.
Then I fall prone instead. I'm only allowed to dodge if I can see them.
Okay.
Same bonus.
You've just been called away. The idea that you're under attack.
Look around.
Hmm?
Look around.
You're looking around to try and see? Yeah, you get that, and you can vaguely see, in the dark. Dark vision, yes?
Yes.
Enough? Yeah. Yeah, you can kind of generally see, a few figures, crouched in that general direction.
How far away?
Within 90 range. Feet.
Okay.
A bit further, but...
So, I drop a globe of darkness on them. And then I charge them. Run towards them.
Okay. Which is, for you, how far?
45 feet.
45 feet.
Are you actually dashing, though?
He can't. He's dropping a globe of darkness.
Oh, yeah. Dash is a movement. I mean, action.
I have those now. Which is the first time you guys have seen me use any magical ability whatsoever. And that ability is to drop darkness. You didn't see shit.
That's why I'm laying on the ground, just...
You can, yeah, as you've half the distance before, you pretty quickly tell that they've, they each in different directions, but they've moved out of the darkness.
That's at the end of my turn.
That's on their turn. That's what they spent their turn doing.
Which was after my turn.
Yes. And then Austin?
Well, I'm on the ground. Have an arrow.
Mm-hmm. I was.
Did you actually catch it?
Yeah. If you reduce it to zero, you catch the arrow.
Oh. Yes.
I could then spend a key point to throw it back, but I have no idea where they are. No, I can't see. I'm gonna stay on the ground.
You do see what direction he's headed?
Yeah, I can't see in the dark.
Okay.
Also, less than half health.
Bigger issue, yeah.
I was like, no, I'm not gonna deal with that.
Get up. I can see in the dark too. See them. I'll grab a torch to at least light up the way as I head out and head towards the ones on the left.
Okay.
Yes. You said they split in three directions,
okay.
Right? I'm going for the one on the left.
Okay. And is your movement's 40, right?
Yeah, it is.
Is it plus another 10 or 5?
10.
So 40, yeah. I do dash, though.
I thought you wanted to grab a torch.
No. Okay. That's a full action and not a bonus action.
Because of where, compared to where you are, assuming you have some sort of small fire that you're grabbing it out of, you would have to go over to it, and you'd actually have to, get it to light.
Okay.
Because unless you're grabbing something like a log that's actively on fire.
No, I just figured there was a, you know, torches on the side of my pack. I'd just take one and sweep it through the fire as I went.
If you just do that, it doesn't light. You actually have this, you know, spend a second or two for it to light.
Okay.
Bob. You can move and get to the center one, who's actually now closest to you, and then still have your action available.
They have a globe of darkness. He can't see through that.
They're outside of it.
Oh.
I move to him, and I start punching him in the face. Well, actually, swording him in the face.
Let's see the middle one.
Okay.
Also, you might want to look and see who or what they are.
No, they shot at us.
Okay. I'm figuring it might be a mistake. They think elves are coming out of the forest.
Oh, they have no idea how big of a mistake it was. 18?
18 is going to hit.
If it was a miss, that'd be a time to run.
Okay, yeah, we're going to go.
10 damage.
Mm-hmm. You know where the power button on that is? Is that the switch?
I was like, it doesn't say a heat problem.
No, it doesn't. It is.
I got it.
Or
fine.
Just sit down. Yeah. We'll try and I'll try and remember to actually show you because you're closer to it. No, once I've done two rounds through, if I go again, it goes about 2 minutes before overheating. I'd rather just not overheat it now that I've figured that out. Yeah, so you deal 10 damage, you say?
Yes.
Use a bonus action to attack unarmed.
He's only got one more key point.
No, not key point, just bonus action.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Key point if you want to attack. Not if you want to slurry.
14? Probably not.
Yeah, 14 hits.
Oh, nifty. 4 damage. Nope, 8 damage.
Because you still get your stat with that, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
With unarmed?
Yeah.
When you make, it's part of your martial arts.
Ah.
When you make an attack with a martial arts weapon, you may spend a bonus action to make an attack with an unarmed strike.
And after that is them, which puts him at a very good spot to strike down.
Drop his bow?
Yes, you can drop something freely.
I know. He drops his bow, though.
Yes, his bow is on the ground.
That's what I was saying.
Okay.
That's all.
I didn't know if he was trying to hit me with the bow.
No.
Basically, no penalty.
He has whatever. What would that be?
Because if he attacks you with a bow, you gain advantage on your attacks against him. But he doesn't actually get any losses.
Except for...
Louie Dion.
So he hits your
scimitar.
Oh. Just say something.
It's for the flavor!
He hits you with a scimitar. Actually, he might. 22, yeah.
Of course that hits me. That would have hit my barbarian.
And 8 means that he does not get his second attack to hit. Only one hit.
So these guys are higher level than us.
No.
He gets 2 attacks.
We could have 3 or 4.
He does 3 damage.
Oh.
So much higher level.
You rolled poorly. That's not my fault.
It's yeah. You are the torchbearer.
Yep. My circle of light should be close enough where Austin can see at least one guy now.
Well, you're getting shot with arrows.
Well, of course.
But 9 probably doesn't hit, but 20 probably does.
Yes.
I probably should have dropped the globe of darkness on the fire.
They have a
definitely wouldn't be getting up.
They have dark vision, but they wouldn't have been able to see
damage, anymore. And you get to...
It automatically succeeds. My bonuses are higher than 4.
Okay. Well, then I don't add just poison, and yeah.
You can spend a key point to throw it back, because you can see him.
And it's poisoned.
It is. Yeah, I'll spend 1 key point.
You are proficient. It is a monk weapon.
So, 11?
Nope.
Hits.
Oh, really?
It does damage to them.
It should poison them, too.
Yeah, they're immune to poison.
Are they really?
Yeah.
They wouldn't give you something that you could use.
Whatever these things are, they're used to fighting monks who routinely throw arrows back at people.
But, Austin? Yeah, you can now begin to see where they are.
How far away are they?
From you, the closest one is probably going to be about
80? 70. That might be the extreme range of your shuriken.
I don't have ranged weapons.
The darts are 60s at longest.
Well, he could move and throw a dart.
Yeah.
I don't have ranged weapons.
You should. Didn't you get... Everyone got shurikens, I thought. All the packs gave you shurikens.
And being a monk did.
Yeah, you have shurikens. You have your darts.
Do I?
Unless you just
didn't
toss them.
I managed to not write those down.
Maybe you got 10.
Yes, you got 10. I forgot to resupply mine, though. I lost one last time.
Mm-hmm. That's why I have bunches of daggers.
Well, they're far more useful.
Yeah. They're also expensive. I had to pay for them.
Mm-hmm. What's dash do? Double movement?
Mm-hmm.
Does it increase your move numbers?
No.
It just lets you move twice?
Dash is you get to move your movement speed.
So you get to move, then move again. Yeah. It's double move.
It is using your action to go what you do in your move.
Okay. I'm going to spend a key point, and I'm going to move directly into melee range from the prone position.
Boom!
As I get up for 5 feet movement, and then proceed to have 75 left over.
Okay. Yeah.
Bonus action! Yeah!
Is that your entire...
That's spooky.
That's your entire turn?
That's spooky.
Is that your entire turn?
No.
You still have...
Now they're getting a beat.
An action. That was a bonus action to move and a movement.
And so, the closest one puts you right up beside Bob.
I have 75 movement. I can pick one they're not fighting if that one's still...
They'd be further.
Oh.
Because the other two presents are scattered to the side. Well, the one that Bob's fighting scattered straight forward.
Kills
that was a bad decision. As he almost seems to teleport in.
Kill stealing.
Trying to decide if you want to fire punch him?
Thinking about it.
I've already tied him up pretty good.
Thinking about it, but I won't. I'm going to hit him normal. I got a spear.
Mm-hmm.
I charged him from a long distance away. Does that give me advantage on the attack? Is he surprised?
Yeah. Let's say yeah.
Was he not expecting this?
I thought there was one of you.
13 and 12. That's super good.
You technically have bonuses in those, but we already established 11 hit.
D8 plus 4.
Their AC is pretty low.
D8 plus 4. Spear, 6 damage. Is he still there?
Yes.
Bonus action. I'm going to punch him.
Didn't you use your bonus to pop up over there?
Yeah, it is true. I had to use bonus on the key point to dash. So that's all I got.
No, 16. Okay. And after Austin is Nick.
Keep going.
Yeah, you can clear the distance. And
crack in the face with a quarter staff.
Mm-hmm. Hey, we had weapons. Sword, spear, staff.
Oh.
Slashing, piercing, bludgeoning. We are a trifecta.
We are.
Anyway, that's really great for what the theoretical end, if everything goes to my plan, of what the story is. Actually, it's really nice that you are that diverse.
We are a trinity.
We're the Rainbow Coalition.
Key point for flurry of blows. Kick him a couple times.
That you are going to notice. You may not be paying attention to very much. But
punch in the chest? Oh, that's weird.
So... 20 hits.
It's like, man, this guy's got a lot of padding on his chest. Oh, not padding.
2 damage and a dex save. The DC's 13.
It gets 13.
Yeah, because it's 8 plus...
Natural 20.
On the attack.
Ha! 5, 6 damage, and a dex save. she falls down! I just crack her in the temple until she falls down.
Prone, I'm guessing?
Yes.
Okay. She's not prone. She failed to save.
Mm-hmm. Now she gets a tax of opportunity if she decides to stand up.
Or disadvantage if she decides to swing from the ground.
Mm-hmm.
Why the tax of opportunity?
Standing up.
No, she has to leave her range.
Yeah. I thought standing provoked.
That's a simple function.
Huh?
Simple function. Use a movement within the range.
Ah.
Nah, man. You need another ability score improvement or feat.
Yeah.
Then you go real nuts.
But anyway, so that's it for you?
Mm-hmm.
And we go back to Bob.
I'm gonna stab him. And I hit him.
Mm-hmm.
And he takes 5 damage. Is he still awake?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to punch him. And I hit him. And he takes 5 damage.
Okay. And he's going to... he's still focused on you. He has no idea what just came up from his side. eight to hit. I'm sorry, 18 to hit.
Yes.
And 19 to hit. So he
kills us.
Maybe. That's 4 damage on one, and 2 damage on the other. You just keep track of what your life health is at in your head, don't you?
Yeah.
It unnerves me, but I guess you only have just you to keep track of, so you probably can, but...
I'm smartified.
I keep track of 3 of them at once.
It's not my fault.
Let's see, so there's that one.
Just make it so when we kill one, they all die. For all encounters.
Okay. Eighteen?
Yes. From the ground?
Yep.
Wait, what'd she roll with disadvantage?
Well, disadvantage because attack from the ground. Also, disadvantage because within melee of someone. But disadvantage doesn't stack, so might as well just keep...
So, what 2 did she roll? Like a 19 and an 18?
They get bonuses to dex, actually, so...
Hmm. Yeah, they're getting +3 on there.
Hmm. They're bad at strength.
But 4 piercing damage doesn't that automatically land?
smack!
Looking at her.
Arming myself. You've lost track of where the third one is, you're not really sure.
How?
Because you don't really know where it is. You don't see him. You know there were 3, and you don't know where the other one is. Austin?
I didn't know where it went off to. The goal would have been to get to the third one.
If you couldn't have got... You know the side that it was at, but theoretically if it was coming for you, it would have come around the globe of darkness. So either it re-entered the globe of darkness, or maybe went around the back side of it, or...
I'm going to go check. I forget I got this one.
Okay. Do you have a light source?
I can.
Do you choose to use a light
source? I have to have an action to produce it.
Okay. Do you?
But I can just set fire to the ground.
Do you make your move and then set fire and see if you could see him?
If I can't see over there, yeah.
Yeah, because, at that point you're going around the globe of darkness that will at that point be blocking off the campfire bit of light that's coming your direction.
And my torch will be on.
And his torch is on the 3, so... But yes, you can kind of see that it looks like the third one is sort of taking a double back to try and get a bit more of a distance advantage for a ranged attack again.
How long does the globe last?
It's a very good question.
As darkness, it's probably concentration like 1 minute.
It's like, after the initial thing... Oh, you've taken damage a bunch of times.
Yeah, I have.
When you cast it as a spell, so you stop him at concentration.
Okay, yeah. It disappears.
Okay.
Probably. They're like DC 10 con saves.
Yeah, but I don't care.
Up to 10 minutes.
Yeah.
But concentration still.
Okay. So once they were out of it, you didn't care.
Yes.
No, I'm going to go. Okay. Anyways, Nick.
I was hoping they weren't going to come out the front so I'd have an extra turn, but one of them did.
It's like, I got a bonus action.
Okay.
There's a guy, right?
Yeah.
I teleport next to him with great speed.
How far can you move with that?
40.
Okay, you make almost half a total distance.
Makes a total movement of 80 from where I was.
But you had to go, cut across one way, so that was that, so only 40 more towards him, and so yeah. You still have 50 feet.
Man, that guy's booking it like a monk might. If this is a training exercise, it's really deadly.
Someone's dying.
Yeah. Nick? Quarterstaff to face on ground.
Wait, if he's that far away, how can I see him at all? Light only gives off, even like any light is only going to control 30 feet.
And then another.
Of thin light. Mm-hmm. Yeah, which is only 60. If I move 40 feet forward and he's still 50 feet away, I'm not even close to being able to see him from where I get.
You can tell.
How?
Because there is ambient light. There are stars, there are things. You can see vague shapes.
My point is, the light I made doesn't actually provide enough light to be able to see them unless I could already see them without it.
Yeah, it does. I'm sorry. Like, in game terms, light goes exactly 30 feet, and then it cuts off to dim light for another 30 feet. That's not how light works.
It is. The game says so.
I am pretending light actually works the way we know light works in this situation.
Bright light reduces your vision radius in dark environments.
That's true.
Hit.
My other point is, if he's that far away, I'm not going to go and chase him down.
Really?
He's got a ranged weapon.
Unless these guys are dark elves after he's gone 60 feet, he can't see us anyways.
8 damage?
Yeah. Well, there's a globe of darkness between
8 damage?
No, they had to fall because...
Well, hold on. I need to...
Made that one.
I did not crit.
Yeah, and if the globe of darkness wasn't there, why'd I have to go around at all? Why can't I go straight forward?
Made that one. Made that one. I only got hit 3 times, so, yeah. I made them all.
Because the globe of darkness is still there.
Oh, then, yeah, I don't... And then I wouldn't want... If he's that far away, I'd go back around the globe of darkness, putting it between me and him.
Okay.
Still have to spend the key point to do it, but I'm not going to get up there where he can hit me.
12 to hit.
Those arrows will kill me.
Yeah.
5 damage.
Okay. Right.
Mm-hmm.
You know, do fancy stuff when they're already on the ground.
Now I only have 1 key point. She might get back up, and I might have to put her back down.
What's her face is still alive in front of me.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I missed.
Oh.
Gravity.
That hits, though. For your double D4.
What, 20?
Mm-hmm.
9 damage.
He falls.
Then it rolls back to them. There's not non-lethal attacks in here, is there?
Yeah, when you make a melee attack, you choose not to kill them.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. 17.
To hit? Yeah, hits.
Okay.
She's making those rolls at the bottom of the ground. Good.
No, she missed.
The guy up on the hill.
The guy firing through
5 piercing damage. No, he's actually around it.
Yeah.
He moved.
As long as I'm only getting hit by one arrow, chances are with the damage they're putting out, it's not happening.
Awesome.
Because minimum is 5
I use
for
the
me.
Darkness cover.
God damn for you.
So you're just staying in cover?
Yeah.
Okay.
You cannot be hit by one ranged attack from these people.
No, I can't.
20, I'm going to choose not to kill her if I do so.
Okay.
In the box.
You're not using an arm, though.
It's a melee.
Oh.
Melee attacks.
8 damage.
When making a melee attack, you may choose not to kill the target, and instead merely render them unconscious.
Okay.
She's still awake? She's still awake, though?
Yeah.
Okay. Team will hit. Do I crit again? No.
Just stomping on this person's
back. As gently as you can.
Yes.
Not as gently, just specifically on, like, the shoulders and things.
2 more damage.
Okay. Specifically not on the vitals.
Pop. I'm putting the boots to her medium style.
Medium style.
There's me stomping on a guy and another guy behind your globe of darkness you can't see.
A ways back. 50 plus feet back.
Through globe of darkness, peek out the other side. I can walk through it though.
Yeah.
Peek out the other side.
Just ahead inside of globe of darkness.
Can I see him?
Yeah.
How far away is he?
50 feet.
Disadvantage darts. Missed. Most likely.
Oh, it would have been a natural 20, oh, but you got actually, 5.
Wait. 11. I forgot. I'm me.
Just you complaining about what is...
7 damage.
7 damage to this new one.
Yeah.
That's the first damage he's taken.
Pop my head back in.
Yeah.
Oh, I win.
Globe of darkness is only 20 feet. So it'd be pretty easy to cross to the other side and get back in the middle of your attacks. Yeah, I don't know what the rule is for attacking something that's completely obscured.
Actually, I can just step out. He can only fire one arrow.
You need a constitution save.
Who, Nick?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's a bad save.
Yep, 11.
11 fails.
It's like I haven't got hit with any of the poisons yet.
You take 7 poison damage from... She puts out her hand and a gas of poison extends towards you. The I'm on the ground there.
Just knock it away.
Not raise missiles.
Yeah, so I do just step out.
However, the other one shoots.
Raise missiles. You can deplete guns, like, you know.
I did step out of the globe of darkness.
And misses. Okay.
So the guy I threw a dart at can see me.
Yes, he's still targeting the one that's got...
Stomping his...
Yeah. He chose targets different than that. That guy hit me with a dart. That one's almost killing my friend.
You think, like, a ballista would count as a missile attack?
Yes.
Theoretically, yes, but in practice, almost certainly.
Well, it'd be almost as certainly impossible to drop that damage to zero.
Yeah, that's the idea behind it. Is theoretically, yes, even if you get that damage, you're probably not. If anything, I could say you managed to, you know, get out of the way along with whatever.
Is the damage they roll low, you catch it. They just go, oh shit.
Terrifying.
Austin?
Yeah. There's a lady on the ground, right?
Yeah, over there with Nick towering over her.
And there's another guy who's on the ground, too.
He's dying.
No, yeah, there's the dead one that's right near.
He's dead?
Yeah.
He got stabbed with some anger.
Yeah, no, I chill out.
You alright? I'm good, look, I'm sorry.
I keep an eye on the one over there.
So you go around to keep an eye on the one in the distance?
Not the distance, the one he's fighting.
Ah.
I don't know why this is a very crit-heavy game.
But it is.
I haven't rolled him.
Well, you're Austin.
Got a little more than a 10.
Have you rolled any 10s?
Way to eventually max damage.
Yes. 9.
9, and do you want to kill her?
No.
Okay, knock her out?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll drop the torch on her and leave.
My god is on fire.
Uh,
No, Peck's back there. Take off shirt, start tying her up.
Now who's taking off their clothes, right?
I have a perfectly good sash.
Isn't that sash what's holding your robe around you?
Yes. Fortunately, I can sleep with my backpack on.
Yes.
Yes, you can. You completely can. Backpack on, in armor. I could imagine at some point you just decide, I'm going to try this armor. Nice and comfy. All right, time to get up for the day and possibly fight things. Better take this off.
To be fair, until he gets 18 and, you know... I think it would affect his speed, too. That's what would make him sad.
Move closer.
Dashing or just enough and then...
Just enough so I'm not disadvantaged on my throws.
Okay. And then, yeah.
No, I want him to use ranged. I don't want him to use anything else. I want him to use ranged. Because he can't shoot me more than...
How many times is he going to have to do that before he knows, I need to close the gap here?
Well, let's see here. Well, he has to deal more than 7 damage with an arrow.
More than?
Yes. 7 damage, I don't even have to roll. So he actually has to do more than 8 damage with an arrow.
They're D6s, aren't they?
D6 plus 1. Hey, just 2d6 poison damage
if it actually gets you. A collection of poisoned arrows.
by the time you find anything else, that poison's dried up.
He takes 8 more damage. Can I throw?
Yes.
Okay,
so I throw again. You have to spend a key point.
No.
Oh, to throw the arrow back.
No. Throw another dart.
Dart. It has light and throwable.
Nope, miss.
Yeah, he'd be weapon handing it.
You sure?
Yes.
Okay.
Well... 10. Does 10
miss?
Yeah. I need to roll a 5. I did not.
Yeah, because that'd be the 2 of fighting rolls. Mm-hmm. So you wouldn't get the stat to the second one.
Well, you missed anyways.
Yeah, we figured that out when the first time you played one.
It was just you, a d4.
Which is still bigger than nothing.
Yeah.
Well, in this case.
Yeah.
I just lost a dart.
Yeah. And after you is... I'm going to assume that he makes your AC and...
No, roll. I want to see how many turns he wastes.
20.
Yeah. Stop that.
No. Remember, he can still crit and then roll 2d6s. And then Bob won't have to roll. But he still has the possibility of shooting Bob in the eye. Granted, that eye shot still does very little damage.
It just barely scratches.
Oh no! At that point, it also does the poison. So,
So at that point, it actually damage. Does.
Yeah, if he can do any damage, then it's the poison that adds on.
Yeah.
Austin.
I'm chilling out.
Okay. Nick.
They all got this.
Making sure bonds are secured. Making sure she's alive.
Nick. No. Your name is
Bob. We're not the same person. Don't even look alike.
Hello. Oops, dude.
All right, let's try... Yep, I hit him.
Okay.
And he takes 9 more damage. And I hit him. And he takes 1 more damage.
I'm going to have to change monk level to 3.
He drops his bow and he runs in the complete opposite direction.
Oh, that's a bad move.
He's booking it.
That's a bad move.
Booking it.
I'm faster than him. That's a bad move.
But how much faster are you?
At least 5 feet. Unless he's a wood elf, then he could possibly have the same speed.
If he's Austin's also an equal level monk.
Nick?
Are you
going to pursue, or are you just going to stay here with your...
Watch her.
All right.
And take off after him.
Okay.
I'll double move.
Yeah.
I pick her up.
And bring her back to the camp, tie her up.
Hey, you know what? I take her and him. No reason not to get a workout out of this.
The dead body?
Yeah, no reason not to.
Okay, so...
No reason
not to
put in
20 feet away from him. I was 20 feet away from him. How far did he run?
He went an additional 60 feet.
Base movement.
Run him down.
You actually get him?
Yeah, I can. I run and I stand in front of him.
He can't also attack.
Okay.
He moves 60 feet, puts him 80 feet away from you. Your move is 45, so 90. You can put 10 feet in front of him.
Yeah.
No, no, cut him off. If he tries to run again, he'll herd him towards me.
Yeah, I did. I ran, got in front of him.
Okay, so you're in front of him. You're behind. It's his turn. Constitution save.
Poison spray!
You might make it. I didn't.
12.
12 equals, which means he beats, right?
No.
He made it.
I beat it.
Yeah. That's yeah. Right. He beats. You beat.
Yeah.
He was you. So, spray in your face, but he moves.
He sprays. You put your hand up.
He moves again, so he's about 20 feet past you.
He moved past me?
Not within that quote, that range.
Did he enter his threatened space and leave it without a disengage?
Nope, poison spray wasn't doing it at a fair enough range, but for being, he is continuing in the direction that he was. But,
it's next turn now.
Yeah. Nick.
Keep running him down.
Mm-hmm. Bob.
He's within
20 feet. You can move and attack. Or just attack.
He can move 20 feet in front of him and attack.
Yeah, I'm going to move up behind him.
Bob's got a 45 foot
stab him.
Or something.
Yeah, I do. That is a D12. That's not even close to the right
place.
If he gets within melee, then the guy can't run away without provoking an opportunity. Yeah.
Is what up only plus 5 speed?
Yeah.
That was 10.
No.
There you go.
All right, he takes 6 damage.
Okay.
And he takes 4 more.
8. Are you in melee?
Yeah.
Then 8.
You... Oh, yeah. 8 damage.
Yeah, that monk one actually gets your bonus.
Oh, so, right. 8, not 4?
Yeah.
Do you, and you're killing him?
Yes.
Okay.
And you're just like, when did you get fast?
No, I've always known
you.
I'm mostly at their speed.
But you're wood elf. We know they're fast.
Yeah, he knows you can be fast. You don't want to be, usually.
I'll race up a mountain.
I'll lose.
It's like foot race? Yeah, I lose, but I'll take shortcuts and I'll make up the difference.
I don't know, he's carrying both bodies back to the fire. I was like, ask you to grab the other end of this to carry it back. So
you're out of your goddamn mind. Get my robe dirty. Walk off.
Carry it back, I'm guessing.
Drag its ass back.
You're going to notice some unusual things here. As you get them back to the fire and can see them a bit clearer.
They're snakes.
Well, snake hole, yeah.
They're,
Of course they are.
Are they snake people?
They're sneeple.
You're gonna notice that the woman seems to have, you might notice one of her serpentine eyes and pointed teeth. The man you have has
long, greasy hair and a big hook nose. He seems to hate Harry Potter.
Hates Harry Potter.
Severus Snape.
He had black eyes.
Severus Snape.
He had black eyes.
I didn't say anything about the eyes.
Black.
But he did.
He has just like the feelings of his diary after he got dissed by that girl he liked.
and the guy has, you know, patches of scaly patches on his skin.
And like actual scales or tattoo scales?
Like, feel like actual scales.
Okay, so not tattoos. Alright, so they both get stripped.
Alright, I want my stuff back.
No, they darts. Might be. They might
you
be.
Spend your time around.
I need my darts. Yeah.
Nope. I've watched these people use bows, melee weapons, and shoot poison spray at people. They get stripped.
Okay.
They get nothing. Just the barest materials.
One of them's already dead. You know that.
Is really?
Yes. I was like, oh,
you're stripping him. Like you're stripping him, berating him. Oh, you're dead.
Okay, the guy is dead.
Jokes on me. Jokes on me. Then I just,
just the lady who's still alive.
Yeah, she gets to maintain minimal modesty.
It's like you check it, but then you put it back on for decency.
You
might want to tie her up with actual ropes and not just my shirt. Yeah, I know you. Our packs are back there. We all have rope.
You find. And if you took from there, she probably dropped her bow and the sword both back there. But
I don't grab them.
Okay, yeah. So those are still back in the field. Otherwise, strapped to her side, she does have a dagger, and she also.
Mine.
You're way the fuck back there.
He's looking around the field for a long time trying to find his stuff anyways.
You'll find the other.
I have night vision.
And there are little bitty things in the grass.
I'm pulling the daggers out of the dude. I missed once. All of my darts are in people.
Mm-hmm. Some of them are broken.
No, a lot of them ended up out.
Because he ran.
Yeah.
Nah, I just pulled. Well, he didn't let me get half, he let me get one third, so.
No, I thought you get two thirds. Slightly more than half. Yeah, I let you get more than half.
So I have a dagger.
Those not really. Yeah, it'll be fine.
You can throw
you also,
and they're monk weapons.
You also find sort of like a gold chain jewelry thing.
We don't have a fancy name for daggers.
Yeah, yeah, they do. It's stupid.
Oh. I have to look up the names.
You called it dagger, and I'm like, what? They're just normal daggers? That's kind of lame.
No, they're ponchos.
I don't know. I almost don't even
know. Tanko. They're ponchos. The non-throwable daggers. It's like, no, they're Western daggers, you know, the throwable kind, not tantos. You don't throw tantos.
Well, Bob's they weren't throwing them, so...
Yeah, Bob specifically has Western-style daggers.
Throwable ones.
I spent money on them.
Yeah, some like golden jewelry as well.
I'm a monk, I can throw anything.
Yeah, yours when you get them
back.
That's
it, snake motif, gold jewelry and a dagger. Mm-hmm.
I also,
is it like a snake dagger?
I also grab the weapons as I walk by back towards the fire. So I pick up her bow and his bow and scimitar and drag those back with him.
I totally want a dagger or two.
They're tantos, so they're not throwable.
Yes, they are.
They shouldn't be, but man,
you want a dagger?
You know how to do it.
Yeah. If you don't, I'm going to take it.
No, no.
You can have two, because there's going to be three total.
But you took one.
Yeah.
And I'm taking one, and he wants one.
Oh. Splitting it amongst us three.
Yeah. Yeah, so...
We all have matching daggers now. Matching tantos.
Well, I just added to my bandolier of daggers that I have. I now have six.
It's like, this is very odd. History of snake people? Yeah, the natural 20 helps.
There's no such thing as snake people.
History of these people.
He's looking and going, you know, the rest of there's no such thing as this. No, there totally are. I can see them.
Historically speaking, there's no such thing as this. This does not exist.
I got 20 of
them. It's like, I feel really, really confident that this isn't right here.
I got 20. What are they?
Snake.
Can I do a nature then?
Yep, that's snakes.
Yeah,
not natural.
I got 11.
Yeah,
it's like,
this does not sit easily with you. This shouldn't be.
I'm much more loosey goosey with it.
I'm like, so can we eat them?
And no,
that's cannibalism. They're people.
They're humanoid, not human.
They're people.
You don't eat elves or humans.
You don't know me.
Well, you don't get to say what I do.
Let's see. Then.
You clearly haven't seen me play Fallout.
Clearly.
It's the sweetest.
18 in religion. Anything in the religious texts talk about snakes?
Let's just wait and ask the elves.
Well, we can ask her when she wakes up.
Yeah, that's how we drag her into the forest and ask the elves.
I feel that's a bad idea, dragging a hostile thing into the elf's territory.
Oh, they trust me, they can deal with it.
Well, yeah, they can deal with it. They might consider us hostile, too.
We got tattoos. They can't attack us.
They that's not true. They usually don't. They accept you as ambassadors. They totally can, and there have been monks that step over their laws and, just have to die now.
Yeah. It's like, on the
safety... One of those laws, clothing-based?
It's like, just for some safety, we should interrogate her.
I'm saying we can do both.
I'm saying we don't need to be in that much of a rush.
I was just seeing a pop-up on the screen, but it's related to a different program.
Yeah. It's like, we don't need to be in that much of a rush. We can take our time and question her before we go into the Elven Force and not piss them off.
That's a point. I'm not in a hurry. I'm just saying we can do both.
We could.
If it's stuff nobody knows about, because you're the one that reads all the books, probably something the Elves know about.
Okay, just spitballing here, but take her back to the monastery. Bath.
Get all that poison dust off you.
Yeah, it's like, she doesn't need a bath. She's a bad person.
We do. This robe is almost soiled.
Alright, so anyway, I'm guessing back to sleep, probably at this point, maintaining a watch both over the area and...
Her?
Her?
Yeah.
I don't have to sleep.
Okay.
And it's like,
do you want to take watch?
I'll take all of the rest of them.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I'm just like, don't worry, I'll stay up the whole time. Okay. I pull out my book. Go off and use the bathroom.
Yeah. You do that for a minute, you come back, you sit around, you read. You have a good old time.
There's nothing written in the book. The book is toilet paper.
That book.
I don't know. At some point, I need to get a book on alchemy so I can start learning that in my spare time to get a proficiency.
250 hours, man.
Mm-hmm.
And money. But we're never given that last one.
Not in our campaign.
We got golden chains. Did all of them have golden chains?
Nope, only she did.
She was the leader. Good thing we kept her alive.
She must have been a leader. Only the leader will get to wear a gold chain.
What's this wee business?
Oh, I kept her alive.
I would have killed her.
Well, personally, I think snake skin would be pretty sweet and cool.
You need to make... Snake skin tattoos.
I'm assuming it's going to be wisdom, but hold on. Is there anything we can tie her to? As opposed to just leaving her tied up on the ground?
Well, I figured we would have, like, hog-tied her and stuff.
Besides, tie her too.
Yeah. A big rock, maybe?
Are there any big rocks around?
No. We're close to the forest.
Yeah, I don't want to tie her to a tree like an offering to
the elves. Here, have her version snake lady.
Wisdom. You need a wisdom saving throw.
Tie her to a flaming log.
No. Didn't make that one. I don't suppose it's some nature of enchantment causing sleep.
No.
Then four?
It counts as charm.
Oh.
He does.
Charm.
Immune to charm.
Are you?
Elves.
Or they might be resistant.
It's either immune or I get advantage. I don't remember which.
Either way, you get another roll, probably.
Mm-hmm. Or you might be immune, so I'll check.
Yeah. Like, I know I have resistance to magical charm and sleep.
Advantage on saving throws against being charmed.
Much natural better. 20.
As she awakes, she says, "Untie me, let me go."
Absolutely knocked her back out.
Unless you miss.
Nope, advantage. She's prone.
And tied up.
And tied up.
You keep her alive?
Yeah. 6.
What happened? She bled out.
It's like, I checked her wounds before I went to sleep.
6.
Spontaneously bled out.
I was using blunt weapons.
You don't see those daring images coming.
So, morning. She's still out.
I'm legitimately reading at this point.
What are you reading?
I have books.
Do you have actual
books?
No, I
have his books.
Oh, okay. It's like, I thought your book was blank.
It is blank. Why would I read what I wrote?
Alright, so we're going to...
Wow. That is something we need to do next time we swing by town, is pick up a med kit.
Like to be able to heal? Yeah. Technically, I believe. I need to double check things. My rules.
It's like, does he get to use those points, or does he need a heal kit?
Long rest. Someone in the party expends one use of the healer's kit, or succeeds a DC 25 wisdom medicine check.
I can't make it!
Do any of you get plus 5 to your...
Well, natural 20 is a success, right?
Sure, I'll give you that. At least you can.
And I also get a plus 5 to medicine.
Which you'd have to roll 20 anyways.
No, 8. Very close to a 20.
Geographically, as the surface of the dice is concerned.
I got 19.
Nope.
Yeah.
Again, in full form.
Yeah, so no health. Although, if you're missing any hit dice, you do still regain those.
We would have to have the head kits to use them.
Yeah, but if you used them before...
From what damage?
You took an arrow.
But I don't have a medkit to spend.
Yeah, that's the problem. We don't have medkits to spend.
Yeah.
Well, that's the point. You're not allowed to spend your hit dice.
Yeah. Without
medkits. But you still regain them if you didn't have them.
Yeah, point being, you don't have to actually make the check in order to regain the...
My point is, we've never had a health kit, so we've never been able to spend hit dice.
I have, but we slept back at the monastery.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I took the beating.
Yeah, that was my only
point. It was your turn.
His bath idea is not sounding so bad now, is it?
Oh, I don't want a bath.
Because it's healing.
That puts you back in the monastery where there are people with...
This arrow is fine. It's basically my friend now. Me and him hang out. This arrow of mine.
It's like, wake
up. This is like my first authentic battle wound.
It's like, some tea first. Looking at her. After tea's finished, wake her up.
Where are you?
I'm standing next to her smiling. Like, do it again. And I'll hit you with again.
I can't charm through people.
And we both have advantage.
Leave this area.
Is she speaking a language we know?
You have to make your...
What she already tried to charm me once.
What dialect is she speaking?
Hmm? She's speaking the whatever the...
Natural 20.
Common?
Standard, yeah.
Punch her in the face. Just seeing if I crit her into super unconsciousness. She takes 5 more damage.
She's unconscious again.
I'm just like, she can charm people. She keeps trying to do it on me. It's kind of cute.
Yeah, it's dangerous.
Oh, gag.
Well,
gag.
Enjoy interrogating her. Gag.
Well, the point is, we can interrogate her safely in the monastery where she's not charming the entire monastery.
Yeah.
No. Yeah, leave this area. If I had failed, we would just pick her up and take her with us.
Yeah.
What's the point? Is no, she's gagged right now.
Yep. Nope. Time to go back to the monastery.
All right. I totally hand you back your book.
Yeah. Put him back.
Haul her up.
You do that. Grab the other guy. Put him on your shoulder, just for them to examine. It's like, do you want to help me carry the other body, or just leave it out here in the middle of the field like dicks? I say we should bring it back.
Animals gotta eat, too.
What he said.
I think more research material is better than less.
We got one.
You got two.
We got two.
Yeah. Well.
Animals gotta eat. Grass grows. Cycle of life.
You're carrying them back?
Yeah.
Are you sticking with the party?
I asked you to this time.
Yeah, this time, yeah.
Just because...
I'm carrying, like, 300 pounds of people. It's work out enough.
Yeah, that and she has the possibility of charming you.
Or con save.
Huh?
Con save.
Oh, yeah. Poison spray.
Mm-hmm.
You want one?
Yes.
Oh. Where does the spray come from?
Hmm? Her?
Like, she just goes...
It comes out of her skin, not through an orifice, because her mouth is covered.
I get an 8. 16?
16? You make it. But you're aware she's conscious now.
No, I just lose care of her. Take a step, body. We're gonna be back. I'm gonna go drag her up a cliff.
Okay, you're dragging her up a cliff?
Yeah.
Away from them?
How
Wisdom save.
Wisdom save? What's she gonna... I'm not looking at her, and she ain't be able to speak. I don't even look at her. She's dragged behind me.
She does need to speak.
That's the point. She's gagged, and I'm not going to look at her eyes. Once I feel I'm probably about half an hour ahead of them, I tell them to keep taking the path.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to, like, tie her up on a cliffside. I'm just going to take a sit for a bit.
Why?
Just going to leave her upside down, hanging off a cliff for a couple minutes.
He's Batmaning her.
That's all.
Where's Dent?
it's kind of exhausting climbing a mountain with a lady.
It's like, I ask you...
So you're sitting up near her while she's dangling off?
Sort of. I mean, yeah.
But you're sitting around there?
But the point is, I'm just looking for something to hang her off of. Mostly just, I need something to hang her upside down from. Blood rush to the head type thing.
Okay.
So ideally not too far away from the path.
Yeah, it's like, I'm hoping I can see
perception
her.
Check.
A perception?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not super good at those. It's like, this girl is dedicated to escaping. I mean, I would be too, but...
You should have just let me knock her out.
If we just keep knocking her out, she never learns. You gotta train things like this.
I feel like knocking her out is training.
No, that's corporal punishment. 19.
19? You noticed the pair of tiny snakes that are slithering through the grass towards your heels?
Oh, man, this girl is, like, straight up dangerous. Snakes, huh?
These, by the way, much more common in this area.
Yeah.
But much smaller, but...
You're just going to stare at the snakes as they come
at
you?
I'm just looking at them. I lift her up and put her on the ground next to the snakes. Mm-hmm. In between the snakes and me.
Well, they're...
They ain't going to chew through him for
yeah, they're going to slither right over her towards you.
Oh, okay. That was all I was checking. That was all I was checking. I was like, is she, like, commanding these? Are these, like, nah, whatever.
They have no way of chewing through the ropes.
Well, they're snakes.
They're snakes. That would be a pointless thing.
They're snakes just trying to invent on the rope. And they're like, huh. Still, got some new information. Go and catch back up to the people on the path.
Just ignore the snakes.
Just leave the snakes in the dust.
Does 19 hit?
Yeah, my AC's 12.
Yeah, well, one of them manages to bite you.
And burst into flames.
Not reactionary.
Not a reaction, though?
No.
Okay, so
no,
bites
it still bites me. I'm just going to shoot flames at it. I have that of power.
You take one damage and need a con save.
I get a plus 2 on con saves. I do not have advantage. I get a 13. Yeah, my con is not.
You take 3... poison damage as well.
Yeah, that's 4 damage.
And then it bursts into flames?
Yeah, then I shoot it with a flame shot on my hands. I let her see that I can do that.
She doesn't seem happy with you.
And you're just like, look at that. Got that snake killed.
You started this. Mm-hmm. That's your fault. You did that. You did that. That wasn't me. That was you.
Keep bringing her. It's like, rejoin us. Look at you.
it's like she could talk to snakes or command snakes or summon snakes.
There's snaky shit going on.
This is probably good information that these snake people unsurprisingly have something to do with their snake problem. Or at least in logic.
We figured it out.
Yes.
Can I knock her out now?
Yeah, go ahead. I'm like, oh yeah, go ahead. I was thinking, you know, maybe we could. Maybe she wouldn't. Maybe she'd try and do something else. But nah, she's pretty dedicated on the attempting to force herself free.
Continue up the mountain.
Mm-hmm.
Also have the other dead body.
Okay. I'm down to keep.
You guys carrying your dead bodies?
She's not dead. No, I will check her after he hits her to administer first aid.
I just deliberately...
Make sure she's not hemorrhaging from the brain.
I deliberately didn't kill her.
You keep trying not to, but you keep giving her enough abuse.
In my defense, she's being a bitch.
She
attacked us, and now she's acting all ornery when she's all tied up.
23 medicine check to keep her alive.
That is not a 25.
Yeah, she her body is fighting against that die at this point.
It's like, no, I'm done, no! Keep her
face
alive.
Face is quite broken.
Okay, but stop hitting her in the face. I mean, I know we all enjoy hitting her in the face at this point. We've all done it.
I haven't hit nobody in the face.
You have soap, right? And you just put it in a sock.
Continue up the mountain. We should get there before
This really shouldn't be this much issue for somebody who's tied up this much.
Yeah.
Magic powers are a pain in the butt.
Yeah, spell-like abilities everywhere!
Yeah. You get up to the bottom stairs?
Yeah.
So I'm sticking with having snake powers was actually pretty sweet. That sounds like a pretty good deal.
Yeah, it's a decent suite of powers, yeah.
Yeah, I'm looking at it like, commanding snakes, having snake power, shooting snake poison. That sounds pretty sweet.
Call for Mr.
Master Wax on. We're really bad at getting onto our quest.
Hey, this is very quest-related.
This is relevant, at least, yeah.
It's like, we were attacked as we entered the jungle.
we were attacked while we were camping next to it.
Yes.
By snake people.
We brought one back. She's still alive, mostly. She probably needs healing for interrogation. She also has magical, mystical snake powers.
Hypnotism,
like poison and hypnotism.
Hypnotism, students poison, summoning snakes.
Yeah, he instructs, some people that can do some, just enough repair to her that, to interrogate and you have a spot to bring her to.
Yes. We also brought a body to see if these are really people. Hey, I am trained in medicine. I know the body. I want to make sure these are actually people, so autopsy.
Well, not autopsy. You gotta cut open and go, yeah, that looks right.
This person is, and that's the kind of thing you could have done out in the field instead of bringing it back.
No, here has paper so I can make meticulous notes and research.
We ask paper you not. No, yeah, here's some paper. Do that outside of the.
Well, fine, I'll go do it outside. But still, we need this information. Yeah. If there are random snake people, we need to know what makes them.
You really should be talking to like the other medical people, not Wax On.
Yeah, no, I'm talking to medical people, not Wax On. He's a martial arts trainer, not, you know, the intelligent, you know, thinky people, I would hope.
He's like our wise master. He's probably got all sorts of crazy sage wisdom.
Yes. But I talk to the medical people who understand, and, you know, we all need some heal treatment.
But yeah, you spend a couple days, you're very disappointed, and,
I just went.
I was like, what?
He poked me with it.
He poked me with intent. Pickles.
But, yeah, they're very disappointed.
I keep the arrow.
You do?
The one that skewered me so good.
Okay.
I keep that one, that's mine, it's so near. Like on a wall.
Where your twig used to be before you started traveling with it.
Yeah.
But, yeah, very disappointed that, the young woman managed to be released.
Not nonsense.
Through some
nonsense.
Clerical error, she was allowed to go.
It's like
she was untied and let to leave.
No. We still told they have the power to mind, so there wouldn't be less than at least two guards.
Mm-hmm. And one outside, too, out of her range.
If nothing else, locked inside a room.
If she gets away, it's plot convenience, not for us lack of preparation and forward thinking.
I concede to that.
Okay. As long as we're not putting this on us, we did everything right. She magically got away.
Yes, in fact, I can guarantee
not she magically, but the magic she has. Other magic. Plot magic.
But yes, you get healed.
I suggest as punishment, we make the guys who let her out go on a full run.
Yeah, okay.
A full run. I'm going to draw them the whole way.
So are snake people basically people, or are they completely different?
You're just like, you want to know who didn't get charmed and let her escape? That guy, as I'm sleeping under the tree.
Mostly people? They're mostly people.
Do they have fangs and poison sacks and stuff like that?
She had fangs, and she had serpentine eyes. Hmm. Her skin might have had a slightly different hue, but mostly normal. No scaly patches.
So this guy had scaly patches, though, but...
Yeah, okay. The guy had scaly patches.
Yeah, that's the one I'm actually...
Yeah, the guy had scaly patches, did not have fangs, did not have serpentine eyes, did have a forked tongue.
Mm. That picture shows scaly patches.
Yes.
But that's
our
not
girl
her.
Doesn't?
No. Okay. That's not who you have.
That's her sister.
I hope not. That's much higher CR than ours.
Hmm?
That's probably higher CR than us.
One?
Oh, no. I can never keep the UNT's names together. Which ones are strong, which ones are weak. There's like seven of them.
Yeah, and the more human workings are, the higher
and UNT rank. Doesn't exist in this world. I'm using generic stat block. Okay. Generic serpentine stat block.
That covers it.
Yeah. But, mostly human, yeah. Other than some of the spots around the patches that seem a bit unusual underneath the...
Yeah, let's check underneath, try to figure out if it's a growth or just natural.
Yeah, it seems to be, something that's it's developed within and grown outwards from within.
Okay. So it's not like a paste they put on to get scales or something.
What?
Alchemy! You rub it on, you get tougher skin.
What?
That happens.
Yeah, it's like Stokes and potions.
Not quite that.
Higher defense potion.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's like, that exists. That's what I was checking for.
So we get back to having to go to the Elves' Nest, though? Is that what we're back to?
Ask them about dragon and snake people now.
But yeah, so you're,
seems like it's go back to the elves.
After some time, healing up, and you set back out towards the elves.
This time I swing by the town to talk to the alchemists, see if I could borrow any books.
What about a heal pack?
And heal packs. Can they give us heal packs?
We have gold jewelry for barter.
He'll give you one medical kit for the jewelry.
I did.
Books are more than that. You get one kit.
How many uses does a kit have?
I think it's 10, but you can check in the book.
You want me, who's trained in it, to have it?
Yes.
Okay.
It's not a check if we have one.
I believe it is for short rest. It's a low check, but you also have to use it. It's if you for long rest, you can just expend it.
Could I get a book off of them for 10 gold?
I do not believe so.
Can you get a book off of them on the grounds of we're monks or one of the elf territories, please?
Nothing like this.
This is like blue. Yeah, you're in the middle of a zombie apocalypse, but that doesn't mean this is free.
Look, I get you got problems, but so do I. Got kids to feed.
It's 25 is the lowest team. Mm.
25 gold. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, I don't have cash.
Yeah.
Don't look at me.
Yeah, you spent all yours on daggers. What did you spend yours on?
I have 10 gold.
Oh. I don't have cash. I just have this 10 gold. The problem is, neither of us have 15 gold.
Anyway, so you get your healer's kit,
mm-hmm.
and you head off towards the jungle once more, and
elven jungle,
mm-hmm. in a freshly jungle. Laundered bathrobe.
And they had a fresh one hanging on your door, ready for you. They know you at this point.
They gave up trying to make you dress.
They also have a pair of lounge pants in case you change your mind.
How does the monastery feel about actual tattoos, not magical ones?
Dangerous.
Why?
Bad precedent.
The beings used that would be used to do it are dangerous. There are some people that are not monks that have them. Many of them who have tried end up dying from the poisons.
I was like, I wonder if I get augment my own tattoos with some fancier, some fancy borders, some calligraphied edges.
Evidently, tattoo ink's made of ricin.
It's like tattoo ink's a pretty old technology that people are pretty good at.
Different world, sorry. Anyways, so you get to the jungle, and that's where we will pick up next time. Have a good day.
So, how much do you expect us to grab her and take her back?
Not even a little bit.
I feel like all these
not at all.
Was because we weren't supposed to have her.
I'm like,
oh god!
I'm just trying to get you to give up and kill her. Like, too much work. Die.
No.
Good.
Extra effort to keep her alive. It's like, oh god, they're trying to unravel the story faster than I want.
I mean, she doesn't really even know enough to tell you what's going on. The fact that you know she doesn't know is enough that puts you a session or two ahead.
Even that information breaks it.
Yeah, because theoretically, she seems like maybe she's leading the thing, something like that. There's something within them that's...
breaking the world.
And now she's alive. Does that mean we get a repeat encounter, or did she learn her lesson?